meet again. Today we're making Flounder Florentine. We have a nice fillet of flounder here. It's just under a pound. It's a heavy piece. Flounder is native from Georgia's Banks. And we're going to do a Flounder Florentine, which I'm going to saute the flounder in a seasoned flour in some olive oil, which I'm going to get started. I already have my pan heating. And about a quarter of a cup of good olive oil. And I checked for, sometimes there's a little bit of a cartilage here in the middle. You just feel with your finger and with your knife just slit it out, which I already did. Seeing that it's such a big piece of fish and it would be a little hard to flip in a pan, I'm just going to cut it in half. Now, in here, I have some seasoned flour, which is a local flour by Drum Rock. And it could be used as a breader or a batter. I'm going to use it just as a breader, dry. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just bread my fish, put it inside of a deep pan, and just coat it really good. And it'll be ready for you as soon as your oil is ready, which is ready. And now we're going to place a flounder and our sizzling oil. It won't take long, maybe 3 to 4 minutes. We don't want to overcook it. Okay, and now we're going into step two. Step two is all our vegetables, which is all local vegetables. Again, I have a frying pan, skillet, drizzle a little bit of olive oil, maybe 2 tablespoons of olive oil, and let it get hot. And in here I have 1 cup of diced zucchini and 1 cup of grape tomatoes, which I've already chopped, and about a cup. This looks like a lot, but it's not. Spinach swells when getting sauteed. And we have our pepper and salt, some chopped fresh garlic, and the last seasoning is going to be 1 tablespoon, which is already measured, of Italian seasoning. As you can see, the fish is starting to get sauteed. Just let it sit. And meanwhile, we're going to start with our veggies. And we do our zucchini, our tomatoes. We're going to do 1 teaspoon of fresh chopped garlic. Black pepper, as much as you would like. I like it spicy, so I add a little bit more. And the same with the salt. Always flavor salt, enhances the flavor and brings out whatever you're cooking. And the last is 1 good squeeze of lemon juice. This is all going to saute together, and now I am getting ready to flip my fish. You can see it's already done in one side, a matter of a couple more minutes in the other side. And meanwhile, I have some cooked white. They're in the house of some jasmine rice, which is a nice complement to this fish. Your fish is almost done. And meanwhile, we have our vegetables sauteing. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it on high and finish it off on medium. We're going to add our Italian seasoning. You can use fresh herbs and you can use dry herbs. In this dish, I'm using the dry herbs, which consists of dry basil, oregano, thyme, and rosemary. I almost forgot about rosemary. And you give it a good toss. Everything is sauteing together now. Blending right in. It's a nice combination. It's a very colorful dish. And our fish is almost done. For this dish, you can use, if you don't want to use rice, you can use any kind of pasta you would like, or even over mashed potatoes is good. Again, you can use any vegetable that you would like, from summer squash to zucchini to anything that's fresh out there. For all our vegetables to use. Are almost done, and so is our fish. And now what I'm going to do is add a little bit of our spinach. The spinach is going to wilt down and blend right in with the rest of the vegetables. You don't have to use spinach. And now we have our platter. I'm going to get this stuff out of the way. We have this in our market. We carry it all the time. It's from a local company in Warwick, Rhode Island. We also have our flounder, which is filleted in our plant daily. And this week our flounder's on special for $6.99 a pound. Maybe $7.99 a pound. I might have messed up. I think it's $7.99 a pound. So our veggies is done. Our fish is done. And now we have our fluffy rice, which was cooked ahead of time to cut back on time here. And this is good. 3 or 4 tablespoons of that. And now we have our sauteed flounder. You don't have to add any salt and pepper to the flounder because the seasoned flour already has the different spices in it. If you don't want to buy seasoned flour, you can make your own. Plain flour, a little bit of cornmeal, salt and pepper, and dry garlic. And now we're getting ready to finish off our plate. As you can see, our veggies are all al dente. And our spinach has wilted. And I finish it off with a little drizzle of olive oil. Always serve with some lemon wedges. And your flounder is done. A quick meal. Delicious. And